Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I'm trying to get some videos done today. Hey, the Lord just gave me a new revelation, brothers and sisters, and it's this. It says in the Bible about the mark of the beast in Revelation, it says that let he who has wisdom count the number of the beast because it's the number of a man, 666. We know that. Now, the Lord began to speak to me in Ecclesiastes. It says, you know, nothing is new under the sun. As it was in the beginning, so shall it be in the end. So as it is at the end, so shall it be in the beginning. And several other Bible verses, the Lord was putting this on me. And then the Lord was telling me, there's lots of people who keep seeing these numbers. 111, 222, 333, 44, whatever, 55, all that's and all these things. And so what the Lord was telling me, brothers and sisters, to look, and I never heard this before. I don't know if anyone's ever taught. Look at the creation week as one type. You know, and we know from the law. See, a lot of people don't know, but five is grace, and we get that from the law because there's five types of sacrifices, the five loaves and all these things. That's where, you know, the biblical meaning of the number five is grace. The biblical meaning of the number six is man. Man was created on the sixth day, all these things. Four is the number of creation, the God of creation, number four. So the Lord is telling me we could calculate, no man knows the day or the hour or the exact moment of the rapture, but we could calculate the timing of his return at the end of the tribulation. All the signs given in the Bible that Jesus gives signs, and I mention this all the time because people don't understand this, the signs that we look for are for the return of Christ after the seven-year tribulation and then the coming of the tribulation. And so before that is the rapture. So the signs we're looking at are pointing to his second return to earth. And so anyway, brothers and sisters, I haven't had a chance to get into it yet, but the Lord is telling me that we can calculate these things by looking at the type and shadow of the things the Lord's been showing you, 111, 222, 333, whatever, looking at the creation week. And the seven, of course, is completion of God. And then, of course, it's rest. Three is the number of God. You know, Father, Son, Holy Ghost. Let everything be established by two or three witnesses, you know, by three witnesses. That's for number two, is two witnesses. Anyway, and number seven is, you know, the day of rest. That's the millennial reign of Christ. That thousand-year reign of Christ is also seven. The Sabbath, the rest on the seventh day that God did in creation, it's all pointing to the millennial reign of Christ, the seven. Now, Jesus, I told this before, and those Judaizers, people who try to keep the law, and I told them, well, you know, Jesus was resurrected on the eighth day. They're like, well, there's not 8 days in a week. Well, there's a new week, a new beginning. See, that Jesus had his passion week. You know, so it's the same season of what the Lord was doing. He entered on Palm Sunday and all those things that week. And then it says he resurrected on the first day of the next week. So that's why it's the eighth day in that cycle of what God was doing, a new beginning. That's why there was eight people on the ark. It was a new beginning. So eight means new beginning. It's the number for the Christianity, for the, you know, the age of the church age is eight. It's a new beginning. As an example, there's a meaning to all these numbers. 11 is chaos. It's bad. You know, it's not 12 is God's government, like the 12 apostles, the 12, you know, the 12 tribes of Israel. God's number of government is 12. God's government is in 12s, like the 144,000 witnesses, 12,000 from each tribe. 12 times 12 is 144, or gross, as they call it. And then the government of man is 10, the 10 toes, you know, the 10 horns and all that. So the government of man is 10. 11 is neither 10 nor 12. So it's chaos. As an example, I just went through a little bit of the biblical number understanding, gematria, whatever you want to call it. Not the New Age numerology, but biblically the way God uses numbers. Like in Revelation, there's seven vials, you know, seven seals, seven trumpets, and seven vials. God does everything in sets of seven. He does everything in sets of seven. But the seven releases the next one. So there's really six seals, and the seventh seal opens up the trumpets. There's six trumpet judgment, and the seventh trumpet opens up the vial. See, so when God does things, it's, you know, it's complete and resting on the seventh. Anyway, that I just wanted to put this video out real quick. I've got lots of more videos to make of the things the Lord has shown me. And lots of times the Lord shows me stuff and I don't make the videos, but I'm determined. I'm trying to push through and make them today. God bless you guys.